Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to reconcile bank accounts in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Similar to your personal bank account, it is important that you reconcile your business bank account on a monthly basis. Reconciling is the process of matching the transactions on your bank statement to what you have recorded in QuickBooks. Reconciling your bank accounts regularly will help to ensure a couple of things. First, any discrepancies between your records and the bank's are resolved in a timely manner. For example, a bank deposit that was posted for the wrong amount by the bank. Second, timely notification of any fraudulent transactions. For example, if you notice transactions listed on your bank statement that you did not authorize, you can notify the bank as soon as possible so that they can investigate. Some of the benefits of reconciling your bank account in QuickBooks are: all transactions on the bank statement get recorded in QuickBooks. Your financial statements, such as your profit and loss statement and balance sheet, are up to date. All of the reconciled transactions are marked in QuickBooks as cleared. You are able to run reconciliation reports that will provide the details of the items that have cleared the bank and those that remain outstanding. Before you follow the steps to reconcile, be sure that you have your bank statement handy for the bank account that you want to reconcile. We will refer to the bank statement often during this process. From the home page, you want to click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name. Below the Tools column, select Reconcile. From this screen, we want to go ahead and select from the drop-down the bank account that we want to reconcile. And then we'll go ahead and select the Reconcile Now button. This next screen is the Start Reconciliation window. And so this information will come directly from your bank statement. So the first field is the account that we've already selected. The second field is the statement ending date. Your bank statement will have a beginning date and an ending date. So enter the ending date for your bank statement here. The beginning balance here is going to come from your bank statement as well. If the bank account was previously reconciled, then this field will display the ending balance of the last month, which is the beginning balance of the current month, and should match your beginning balance that appears on your current statement. The ending balance here. This is the balance in your bank account as of the statement ending date. So we want to enter the ending balance here from our bank statement. So for example, here our ending date is January 31st, 2016. So we want to enter the balance as of this statement date in this field. And then we'll go ahead and click OK. On the next screen, you're going to see the checks and payments listed on the left side, and the deposits and credits are listed on the right side. So these are all the transactions that are currently in QuickBooks. Before we begin to match up transactions, we want to double check and make sure that the information that we entered from the bank statement is correct. This information appears at the very bottom of the screen to the left. If we need to edit any information that we entered from the bank statement, you would just click the link that says Edit Information from Statement. And then it will take us back to that first screen where we could edit the statement date and the ending balance if necessary. So we'll go ahead and cancel out of that since we're fine with both of those. The next thing you want to do is we want to hide transactions that do not fall within the statement date. So if you click this box here that says hide transactions after the statement's end date, it will remove any transactions after our statement ending date. So for example, our statement ending date is January 31st, 2016. So any transaction dated February 1st and after will be removed from this screen. So let's begin with checks and payments. Referring to your bank statement, for each check or payment that appears on your bank statement, you want to go ahead and check it off in the reconciliation window by clicking the box to the left of the transaction. So we're going to go ahead and do that for each of the items that appear on the bank statement. And QuickBooks will put a check mark in it once we mark that box. One tip that I'll also give you is as you're marking these transactions off in QuickBooks with the check mark, you want to go ahead and put a check mark on that paper statement as well. And that way you can keep track of everything that you've marked off. And then what we'll do is we'll do the same exact thing for our deposits and credits. So that section is a little bit shorter. We'll mark those two items off as well. And once we have done that, we want to check and see what our difference is. We are trying to match to a balance of zero. So it looks like we are out of balance by $18.34. So to figure out our out of balance, the first thing that we want to do is make sure that the amounts that we have in QuickBooks match our bank statement totals. So taking a look at our deposits and other credits total, we want to make sure that the total that we show in QuickBooks here matches what the bank statement has. So we'll do that. And then after you check that and make sure that's good, you want to double check your checks and payments total and make sure the total that we have in QuickBooks here matches our bank statement. So it looks like we are out of balance here by $18.34. And what do you know, if you look up above, I forgot to mark an item off here for $18.34. So we'll go ahead and put a check mark next to this item, and then that should put us at a difference of zero. So once we're at a zero difference, that's fantastic. If you have a difference and you're having some trouble balancing, I've shared some troubleshooting tips with you later on in this lesson. So once we've got a zero difference, we are able to go ahead and click the Finish Now button. And once we click the Finish Now button, that will actually do a couple of things behind the scenes. QuickBooks will mark all of the items that we put a check mark next to as cleared. It will also generate our bank reconciliation report. I want to share a couple of tips with you when it comes to bank reconciliation reports. The first tip is you want to create a folder to keep all bank reconciliation reports in. I recommend one folder per bank account. The second tip I have for you is bank reconciliation reports are one of the top five reports that auditors will request. In my experience as an auditor, if you are unable to produce these reports, I can promise you that the audit will not go well. So we'll go ahead and click on our reconciliation report that's been generated. And here we are. So at the top here, you will see a summary of the information that we reconciled. So we've got our statement beginning balance, and we've got our checks and payments total, our deposits and credits, our ending statement balance, and our register balance. Most important, this was the goal of reconciling, is to make sure that we match up our bank statement balance with our QuickBooks register balance. So as you can see, both of these match. And then we've got the details of all the items that were cleared here for this particular reconciliation. So if you'd like, you can go ahead and print this report out and share it with those that need to review the report. Let's talk about 10 troubleshooting tips for reconciling bank accounts in QuickBooks. Try some of these tips if you're having trouble getting to a difference of zero. First tip I'll share with you is when you first go into the reconciliation tool, after you enter the statement ending balance and the statement ending date, if there are no transactions that appear on the screen, then there are one of two things that could be causing this issue. The first is you may have transactions sitting in review, waiting for you to categorize them and add them to the QuickBooks register. In our lesson on managing downloaded banking transactions, we walk through step by step to show you how to review your downloaded banking transactions and add them to the QuickBooks register. Click here to watch that video tutorial now. The second issue that could be taking place is you might have entered incorrect information from the bank statement. So remember how we checked that earlier. In the lower left-hand corner of the screen, there's a link that says edit information from the statement. So if we select that, we can double check to see if our ending statement date is correct and our amount is correct. So we'll go ahead and do that now. And yep, looks like I have entered the incorrect year. So we'll go ahead and change that and click OK. Voila, we have transactions. So the next tip that I want to give you is you want to narrow the search down to the type of transaction. So in this example, as you can see, we have a difference of $2,547 and some change. So you want to figure out if that difference is on the checks and payment side or on the deposits and credit side. So again, to do that, you want to look at your total in QuickBooks and compare that to your bank statement for each of those and to see which one is out of balance. Now, if both of those are out of balance, then tackle them separately. Balance the credits and deposits first, if that's shorter and faster, and then go over to the checks and payments side and do that. You can also look for the exact dollar amount that you are off. So if you recall when I reconciled the bank statement a few minutes ago, we had an exact amount that I had forgotten to check off. And so by simply looking for that dollar amount on the screen here in QuickBooks, and then if you can't find it, you can also look on your bank statement. So if we looked at our bank statement to see if we could find an item for $2,547.25, that might help you figure out what the problem is as well. Next tip is triple check the information that you entered from the bank statement. So we've done this a couple of times, but it is important that you make sure you didn't transpose a number or enter the date incorrectly as I just did. So again, clicking that edit information from the statement link will help you to verify that information. The next tip is to check and see if there's any transaction in the reconcile window that you did not check mark next to, right? So that's what I did earlier that we discussed. And so if that transaction is on the bank statement, then it should have a check mark next to it in the reconcile window. If you do have a transaction on your bank statement that is not in QuickBooks, then you will need to add it to QuickBooks, okay? So to do this, what you want to do is go ahead and click the Finish Later button. Now remember, the Finish Later button will save all the work that you've done so far, so you can easily come back and pick up where you left off, okay? If the missing transaction is in the checks or payment section, then you want to enter it as you normally would. In our How to Write and Print Checks lesson, we walk you through step by step on how to create a check in QuickBooks. Click here to watch this video tutorial now. If the missing transaction is in the deposits or credit section, then enter it as you normally would. In our How to Make Deposits lesson, we walk you through step by step on how to record deposits in QuickBooks. Click here to watch this video tutorial now. Next tip, take a break. If you've been at it for a while, you probably need a break. So go ahead and click that Finish Later button to save your work. And then you can easily pick up where you've left off. Sometimes taking a breather and coming back can help you spot what's causing the difference. And the last tip is, while it might be tempting, do not click that Finish Now button until you have a difference of zero here. The problem will not go away, I promise you. The difference will just carry over to the next month until you figure it out. If you do hit the Reconcile button and you have not figured out the difference, QuickBooks will record the out of balance in a miscellaneous expense account called Unreconciled Discrepancies. Of course, if we're talking a small amount, like $5 or less, then it might be worth your while to move on. At the end of the day, you get to determine what amount you are comfortable with. Reconciling your bank accounts does not change your financial statements. However, behind the scenes in QuickBooks, the items that have been reconciled are flagged. So let's go ahead and navigate to the check register and take a look at these now. To navigate to the check register, we'll go back to our home screen. We'll click on Transactions and then Banking. And then you want to click on View Register to the far right. And notice in this column, the letter R. So every reconciled check and deposit will have the letter R in this column. Typically, once a bank transaction is reconciled, you do not want to make any changes to it. This is primarily due to the fact that you have balanced it with your bank statement. You can edit the account if you need to. If you categorize something as meals and entertainment, and it should have been office supplies. That's fine. But you do not want to make any changes to the date or the amount. If you do, it can cause your financial statements to be inaccurate and you will no longer be in balance with your bank. That wraps up the lesson on how to reconcile your bank accounts in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.